Hello everyone, this is a new video. I'm trying to be consistent, it's not easy, but this is a new video about conjugaison progressive du français. That's the same series as the other book, Communication progressive du français. And that's a new edition. I cannot send it to you guys, I'm sorry. I need to respect some rules. And okay, so let's get started with to be, to have. A lot of people feel like they know it and they always make a mistake either here or here or here. So the pronunciation is essential. And also, this is also an important, we call it an auxiliaire, it's like an auxiliary verb. Because it is can be used in composed tenses, like the passé composé. Let's say for instance, je suis allé, so you guys can say I went or I have gone. It's to have in French, but to be it's to have in English, but to be in French. Okay, so être, to be, je suis, tu es, il, elle est. We can also add the on. I don't know if you remember this one. On is like oui. Actually, I'm gonna write it. It's gonna be easier. So we can also add on, it's like one, we, everyone. Okay, so but this one has an liaison, so we say il est, elle est, on est, there's an N sound, on est, nous sommes, vous êtes, ils sont, elles sont. So be careful of this S sound, there's no Z sound, ils sont, elles sont, vous êtes. Et this one, also we need to have on est. Okay, cannot write here. Anyway, je suis, tu es, il, elle est, on est, nous sommes, vous êtes, ils sont, elles sont. Okay. So we can use this for different expressions, of course. Être indique l'état ou l'heure, so the state, how you feel, and the time. Il est français, je suis avocat. Elle est grande, tu es en colère, êtes-vous malade, ils sont en retard, elle n'est pas à l'heure, il est 8 heures, quelle heure est-il? So let me read it again. Être indique l'état, l'heure, il est français, he's French, je suis avocat, so that's a masculine form, I'm a lawyer, elle est grande, she's tall, tu es en colère, it means to be angry, okay? You are angry, are you angry? Êtes-vous malade, are you sick? Ils sont en retard, they are late, so to be late every time, right? It's to be French. So être français, être avocat, être grande, être en colère, être malade, être en retard. Elle n'est pas à l'heure, she's not on time. So être à l'heure, il est 8 heures, être 8 heures, it's not his, but it is 8 o'clock. We don't know if it's a.m. or p.m. Keep in mind, in French, we like to use the military time in order to specify the p.m. time, so afternoon, evening. Quelle heure est-il? Il, en fait, it's kind of hard here to understand why it's est-il. It's like, what hour is it? Because il can have the, I mean, we can say it's he, but it can also be a masculine it. Quelle heure est-il? So we call this verb auxiliaire. It can be used to build composed tenses. Okay. Construction particulière, so particularly construction. This one's really, really special, but c'est can be it is or this is. That's a plural form. Ce sont, c'est, ce sont, these are or those are. Sont utilisés pour présenter quelque chose ou quelqu'un. They are used to present somebody, something or somebody. C'est ma voiture, it's my car. Ce sont des oranges d'Espagne, these are oranges from Spain. D'Espagne, so this T apostrophe stands for from. C'est un ami, it's a friend. Ce sont mes enfants, disant my kids, my children. Ce ne sont pas des légumes. Ce ne sont pas des légumes, disant not vegetables. Ce sont des fruits, disant fruits. Ok. Bon, you already have the answers because I did it not too long ago, actually. Tu es Alsacien. You are from Alsace. tu n'es pas Alsacien. Donc, tu es Alsacien. It's gonna be better to drop the liaison. Sometimes it's too heavy to put liaisons everywhere. It sounds really, really heavy. So it's kind of a, you know, irrational rule, you know. So it's just based on the sound. So tu es Alsacien ou tu es Alsacien. If I want to speak faster, I have one. Tu n'es pas Alsacien ou tu n'es pas Alsacien. It's fine like this. So Alsacien is a person who is from Alsace. It's a region in France, eastern side of France, and it's on the German border. Il est traducteur. He's a translator. Il n'est pas traducteur. So every time it's a negative form right here. Vous êtes musicien. Are you musician? Ils, elles sont en voyage. They are on vacation or traveling. Nous sommes en forme. To be in good shape, to have energy, to feel great, basically. Je suis triste, I'm sad. Il n'est pas traducteur. Vous n'êtes pas musicien. Ils, elles ne sont pas en voyage. Nous ne sommes pas en forme. Je ne suis pas triste. Ok. It's all about the conjugation. Hein? So, elle est française. She's French. Je suis étudiant. I'm a student. Ils sont au cinéma. They are at the movies, theater. Tu es sportif. You're an athlete. On est à la maison. We are at home. Vous êtes libre ce soir. Are you free tonight? Il est midi et quart. Be careful of this one. It's a K sound. Il est midi et quart. So it's like noon and a quarter. So 12, 15. Nous sommes très contents. We are very happy. Elles sont en retard. They are late. Vous êtes pressé. Are you in a hurry? Okay. Mathilde et son frère sont en colère. Mathilda and her brother are angry. So be careful, there is always to be, hein, before these expressions. Je suis... it could be this, hein. I think I forgot to add this one. Je suis informaticien. Je suis grand et mince. Je suis en colère. Je suis américain. Je suis blonde et petite. Hein, it can also be this. Let's add it like this. I'm sorry for the mess. Voilà. Léa, vous êtes mariée. Hein, vous êtes not mariée because vous êtes italienne, n'est-ce pas? Aren't you? You are Italian, aren't you? Oriane et moi sommes mariés. So married. Tu es américain. Matthew est américain. Il est en colère. Il est grand et mince, informaticien, il habille 11 guys. Hein. Marie est blonde et petite. We could say that as well. Marie est italienne, n'est-ce pas? Marie est en colère. Hein. We cannot use those guys because they are masculine and Marie is feminine. Ces roses sont magnifiques. Voilà, we're not gonna say the roses are married. Now, c'est un bel hôtel. So, bel is a form of a masculine form, but because it starts, it's close to a noun starting with an H or a vowel, we're gonna have what you call the fifth form. So, let me just tell you quickly here. So we have beau, so that means beautiful. Hein? Beau is beautiful. That's a masculine singular form. So masculine singular form. After we have, let's use a plural form, beau with an X, which is a masculine plural form. After we have belle, okay, which is a feminine singular form. And after we have belle, it's the same pronunciation, feminine plural form, okay. And after we have this one, because it's close to a noun, starting with an H or a vowel, okay? But it's a masculine noun. Let's say that, masculine noun, with a starting with an H or a vowel, okay? C'est un bel hôtel, it's a beautiful hotel. Ce n'est pas un bel hôtel, it's not a beautiful hotel. Ce sont de très bons amis, these are very good friends. Ce ne sont pas de très bons amis, they are not very good friends. C'est un film magnifique, it's a magnificent or great movie. Ce n'est pas un film magnifique. Ce sont nos correspondants. So, if I say it slowly, it's going to be like this. Ce sont nos correspondants espagnols. And if I say it fast, ce sont nos correspondants espagnols. So sometimes I add the liaison if it's fast. Okay, if it's slow, it can be heavy. C'est mon professeur de français. So correspondant is a pen pal. Prof can be also short for professeur. We can also use a feminine form. C'est ma prof de français. Ce sont des fraises, ils sont strawberries. So be careful. Ce ne sont pas, ce n'est pas, ce ne sont pas, ce n'est pas, ce ne sont pas. Okay. So this is a short lesson because it's all about to be. Be careful. Do not neglect this verb. It's a very, very important verb. And next video will be about avoir. Bonne journée. Au revoir.